When the user logs in, here's the screen where all the activities, the introduction of our app is seen. So this screen is a list of all the features incorporated in our app. The symptoms, the do's and don'ts, the helpline, a list of all the helpline numbers that if a person might need during the pandemic. The statistic feature, here's a simple page that shows the real-time worldwide statistics of the number of deaths, confirmed and death cases, which is updated multiple times a day, which is fetched from an API. The most important feature of our app, the Get Travel Pass feature. There might be situations like medical emergencies, need of basic amenities like groceries, a person who want to lend a helping hand for NGOs and want to go for donation drives. So let's take an example for medical emergency. Here the user fills the nearby hospital name, which is suggested. The number of people accompanying him. Here we have set a limit of maximum 2. The details of the member who is accompanying. So this QR code is generated with the details of the patient, which is in the encrypted form. So when he clicks it, get it verified. A request is sent to the concerned authorities or the concerned doctor, which is on opposite end. Once he verifies this QR code with a digital signature, a notification is popped up and a QR code is generated with the status, which is verified. The black and white color of the QR code indicates the QR code is unverified, and the blue and white color of the QR code indicates that the QR code is verified. The next feature is listing all the donation centers for blood, money, and food. So here a user can get the list of all the donation drives where he can donate and read about the details of the funding schemes going on.
We have been a part of Yantra past 2 years, and the learnings out of this are commendable. So Yantra focuses on learning by competing ideology. So this was an opportunity for us, for our team, to come up with something unique and provide a helping hand to serve the cause and devise a response to the ongoing challenges. The important factor of this competition was a shorter timeline. So proper time management and task distribution between the teammates, so that can be done easily and in a short amount of time. That was a key aspect here. And we learned about how to prioritize things.
It was an opportunity to discover some other technology, like developing in a Flutter and making UI, connecting it with Firebase. So we learned these new things.
We first started with the brainstorming. So we made a Google Doc, so where we can put our ideas together. So the points each one of us had in our minds was noted down there. We discussed over it, we had con-call, and we did other things. After that, we made a proper schedule how that can be done. Like the first part was making the UI. Side by side, Pranjal started doing the UI. And we were trying to search for other APIs and resources that can be integrated in our app. So side by side, the backend part we three were doing. The main purpose what we did was implementing what we have learned. Since there was no time to learn something new and implement. So the available resources and the available learnings we already have, we tried to incorporate.
During this time, we also had a problem of time management, because when this hackathon came, we also had some lectures going on in our college. So at that time, we had to manage our time properly. So what we did was that each one of us is not in the same batch. Some are in one batch, some are in other batch. So we saw our timetable and then we managed our time. If some person is free at some particular point of time, so that person will do part of the application, he will do the development, and then when he is not free, the other person gets free. So this is how we manage time, so that in the 10 days we will be able to complete the project. Every other iteration, there was some or other changes that I did in the UI designing, because not in a single go the UI is perfect. So after every iteration, like if we wanted to add a new statistics page or a new feature that we wanted to add, so there had to be some changes to be done in the current UI. So time to time, the UI was changing according to the features that we were going to add in it.
We got to know about the competition on April, in the month of April. So the 15 days, like, we were doing nothing, and within the 10 days we started working day and night. So our parents were like, what happened? The child was doing nothing and he started like working for day and night. So this was basically the reaction of my parents.
We have been participating in Yantra for the past 2 years, two competitions we participated, and my parents was like, again Yantra. That was an opportunity for us to again participate, because in the last competition we didn't qualify for the finals. We tried our best, but we couldn't reach the finals. So we were depressed because of that. This was again an opportunity for us to participate and contribute again. So we didn't want to miss this competition. And my parents were really happy and they said, ki karo achhe se aur. Corona virus pe kuch app bana rahe ho, humne yahan se.
For the past like 2 years, we have been participating in the robotics competition, and it's like a long competition for two, three months. So we have been away from our homes like for 10-15 hours after college hours, overnight stay even at the college. So like for this winning this competition, like the hackathon is something very good for us.
We also stayed at college for nights. We had sleeper over college to complete that deadlines in the robotic competition. So we had very personal attachment towards the Yendra competition. So finally winning an hackathon was very great for us.
Yendra competitions are always very structured, and they like the target in everything, the target specific set of skills that you will learn over like 3 months. So in the last 4 years, whatever engineering that we have done, like these phases of Yantra, like three months, have been the best learning phases. Practically learning how to do a PID, implementing a like a line following bot or search algorithms, various concepts that we learn theoretically but we cannot implement practically, we were able to implement in Yantra. For the past 2 months, everyone has been in lockdown, so like the productivity has gone down. So these kinds of competition help us like in concentrating our mind towards like developing a good solution to a problem rather than wasting our time.
The robotic competitions was more like learning and doing something, and this was like more of brainstorming into what the problem is. So in their competitions, we had to learn various different algorithms, various different concepts. But here, we just have to apply it, we had to just implement it.
The Yantra Hackathon has been conducted by IITB, and like at the end of the hackathon, you get a fantastic internship opportunity to work with like the professionals, the professors at IITB to develop a practical project. So that is one aspect, and the other aspect is for example, the robotics competition is a very long competition. It takes 3-4 months, but you learn a lot of things. But hackathons are very bite-sized competition which you can just enter and develop something fast and deploy it.
Yantra will be an emotion for our in the engineering journey, because in the second year we get to know about the Yantra competition. So we participated in it, and we had an idea that if we win the competition, we get an internship in the IIT Bombay for a project. So we had an emotion to it, and we had a feeling that we have to win it once in the engineering journey.
As an engineer in a college, we don't get to do all the stuff that we are able to do. Like in college, we just have to attend lectures, do assignments, do some projects and anything like that. But the competition like Yantra, it brings us out from our comfort zone, and we get to learn a lot many things that we don't learn in engineering colleges. So that's what Yantra means to us. It's like a learning that is only given by Yantra, and that cannot be given by any other university or the other colleges.
I define Yantra basically as an opportunity for learning by failing and learning by computing. So that's what Yantra means to me.